to you who fear my name, that the Son of Righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings. You shall go out and go forth like stone-fed calves. You shall trample the wicked. There shall be ashes on the soles of your feet on the day that I do this, saith the Lord of hosts. But guess what? Jesus Christ is not coming back just to shake everybody's hands. No, he's coming back, the Bible says, being revealed from heaven with his mighty angels in flaming fire, to taking vengeance on them that know not God and do not obey the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. That these shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power. So the question is today, if Christ was to come back this very moment, where will you appear? Where are you gonna be? Where would you end up? Because if you don't know God, understand the wrath of God is already abiding upon you. So the question is, I'm obviously in the right place. Obviously, I'm in the right place. Jesus came to save sinners. And listen, if you're a man, be a man. If you're a woman, you don't have to stress out and work hard to act like a woman. If you're a woman, you're gonna act like a woman. But why do men act like women and women like men? Well, it's because there's a spirit that is oppressing you. There's a spirit that you got, and you need deliverance. You need deliverance of demons. Yes, Jesus came to deliver you. Now you need deliverance. You know, the Bible says that just as Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities about them in like manner, they gave themselves over to sexual immorality and going after strange flesh, to are set forth as an example, suffering the vengeance of eternal fire. And you know, many people shake their heads at the gospel. Many people shake their heads at the gospel. I will let you know, the day of judgment, no more shaking of heads, no more denying, no more laughing, no more joking. All those things will be brought to nothing. You're gonna stand before a holy God, and you're gonna bow your knee to Jesus Christ. You should bow your knee now in repentance.
I know you're coming here to support, you know, probably the next president of the United States. But I want to tell you something. There's already a ruler, and his name is Jesus Christ, and he's gonna judge both the living and the dead. Understand? If you want to vote for somebody to rule this country, vote someone who's godly. Vote for someone who doesn't support the murder of babies in a womb. Vote for somebody who honors and glorifies the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, our Creator. If you're going to vote for somebody, vote for someone who honors God. If you're going to vote for somebody, vote for someone who fears God. If you're going to vote for somebody who gives praises to God. But understand today, just by you choosing him, you don't honor God. You support the murder of babies in the womb in the name of choice. In the name of choice. Well, you should be glad. You should be glad today, that your parents didn't make that choice, or else you would not be here today. And so I want to let you know today that the problem, the solutions is not found in government. The solutions is not found in your money. The solutions is not found in relationship. It's found in Jesus of Nazareth. You know, the Bible says, why do the heathen rage? Why do the heathen rage? And the people plot a vain thing. They take counsels. They gather together to take counsel against the Lord and against his anointed. Let us break our cords. Let us break our cords from them. But I want to let you know today, Jesus Christ can break your cord of sin. You need to be set free. You need to be set free. Some may go to church, don't even know what the gospel is. The gospel means good news or glad tidings. and we come out to bring you good news. But all I've been hearing is bad news. It's the same thing over and over again, every 4 to 8 years. And over and over and over again, the same old thing. You keep falling for the same old trickery. And I want to let you know today, Jesus Christ won't deceive you. He won't deceive you. Jesus Christ actually came to save you. He came to give a new mind, a new heart, to set you free from the bondage of sin, to honor righteousness, to hate lawlessness. The Bible says that Jesus Christ loved righteousness and hated lawlessness. Lawlessness. No, a lot of our presidents have been honoring lawlessness. And I want to let you know today, when you come to Christ, you can know what true righteousness is, because He is righteousness. He is the standard of righteousness. So we came to lift up a standard, and that standard is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Understand? Each and every one of you will stand before Christ. The Bible says that we all must appear before Bernie Sanders. No. The Bible says we all must appear before the judgment seat of Christ, Jesus, to give an account of everything done in the body, whether it be good or whether it be evil. It says, therefore, knowing the terror of the Lord, we persuade men.